je all over the place. It's going to be an editing nightmare again. What else is new? You know? I just kind of poked myself in the eyeball and that's never a good idea. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today, my first impression on the Revolution Reloaded Blackout palette. The background is a bit different because I, well, basically went rearranging my beauty room this weekend. So yeah. To save time, I kind of, you see my face done. I did try out two things in the video already, which is this one from Revolution, that liquid highlighter that came in, what was it, a gift with order. So I will insert that clip now. Let's see. Ooh, she pink. There it is. Okay, so, wow. I have some there. So let's kind of, I don't know, swirl a brush and then do that. I don't think I like that, but still, let's not be too hasty. Maybe I should have put this underneath my foundation. I don't know. Or mix it in, but I feel like it is removing. It is removing. I don't know how to work this stuff, guys. It's removing my foundation, which is annoying the hell out of me. It's the super stay. It should stay put. So let's just step over it with a finger. Get my brush. And put back a little bit of foundation, basically. I have not powdered it yet. The super stay usually stays put for me. Maybe I use too much. I don't know. Okay. So yeah. It's not really for me, I think. But anyway, yeah, let me know if how you use stuff like this. I cannot get it to work, apparently. I don't know. And then the eyeball highlighter. Oh, this is so squishy. I like these so much. This is the white one. I already tried the pink one in my Revolution haul that I will link down below as well. I will insert the clip of me putting this one on now. I do know, however, that I like this better applied with a fluffy brush. So I'm going to do it and I'm going to apply it underneath my blush today. Okay, so it looks to me... Ah, there it is. That pinky one that I have was actually more, I don't know, pigmented than the white one. I'm not hating it. Let me get a different brush. One that's a little bit smaller. Yeah, that's better. So here I have one from Nabla. You can also use, I don't know, a very fluffy eye brush. Some are so big that for me at least, they don't work for my eyes. But I use them for highlighter brushes. Yeah, I like this brush better. And for that pink one, I actually prefer a bigger brush. I probably do have white stripes, but you know what, I don't care. And my blush is going on top of it also. And maybe even bronzer, because I kind of forgot to bronze. What about bronzer? Okay, so yeah, that was that. What I did do though, I put my blush and powder bronzer on top of the highlighter, and it's still really, really nice. So yeah, I did prime one eye already with the Essence Eye Heart Color Intensifying Boost thingy, whatever. And I'm ready to apply some eyeshadow in just a minute. I do, however, want to swatch her. I did swatch her in my haul, but I'm going to swatch her again. I'm going to go row by row. I'm going to, sorry for the shine, going to start here, go like that, on a clean bare arm without primer. And I'm going to speed through it. Put a little bit of music underneath. Oh, this feels really nice, by the way. So here are all the shades. Some swatch better than others. And I do have to say that when I dug my fingers in for the first time in my hole, they kind of felt a little bit drier, but maybe it was just a top layer, because now that I'm swatching them again, they feel somewhat softer. Not buttery, but still a bit softer. So I have some grays in... I'm going to clean my arm in just a second. I have some grays in the Juvia's Place Nubian 3 Coral Palette. The mattes are very, very nice. And I kind of want to work with the gray mattes here as well. So the shades I am going to play with regardless... the matte shades I'm going to play with are this one, which is a dark gray. Then probably this one, which is the light gray. And it could very well be that I'm going to deepen it up with one of the blacks. But here are the two. So let me swatch this one again. And then maybe even this one. I'm not sure yet. Let's see. I'm going to put them on my hand. First the light one. Oh, it feels so creamy. Here is the black without flecks. And here the one with. This one feels weird though. So yeah. This one doesn't seem to be a true matte. But I'm going to use it anyway. So I'm going to use those for my mattes. And we will see from there. Let me remove some stuff and get my brushes. Okay. So I have here a fluffier brush from BH Cosmetics. I'm going to start with the darkest of the matte gray. I will point it. This one. They don't have shade names, so yeah, I cannot tell you the shade names. But I'm going to put that in the crease. She a bit powdery. And I haven't set the base, so instead of really stamping it on, I'm actually going to do a stamp and swipe motion. So that it can kind of blend at the same time. Looks to have a little bit of a shimmer in it, so maybe this is a satin, I don't know. It's pretty, but weird. Okay, I'm changing to a smaller brush, because I want to kind of connect it underneath a little bit as well, to my lower lash line. Okay. Let me get a fluffier brush. Going to blend out the edge first. This brush is clean. It's very easy to blend it. I'm going to grab that lighter gray matte. I do really need to dig in constantly, I feel. Now I'm going to go back to the darker gray for the edge here. Yeah, they blend nice. They blend easy. It is a satin, that darker gray. I do feel that if I blend too much, I blend it away. Just saying. I'm going to go with this black first, which is the one without flecks. This is the one with flecks, that one. I'm going to use that one. I'm going to deepen up the outer corner. So this black is, or maybe it's even a very, very dark gray. It's not overly pigmented, which is not bad for a black. That means that you can, I don't know, really easy better control it. That gray that I put in my crease, though, is a satin. I can see it shining through. But yeah, it is what it is. I don't mind it too much, and it looks pretty, but just so you know. That was pretty effortless, guys. Wow. Let's see what happens if I grab that one with flecks in it. So that other black. Still the same brush. Let's see what that one does. If that even wants to layer on top of what I just put down. It does layer though. Because it's a lot darker now. So that one is a lot more intensely black pigmented than the black that I used. Let's see if we can kind of blend everything together a little bit. I'm concentrating my blending on the low crease. So where I put that black. Okay, I want a little bit of that, that gray back. Even though it is a little bit of a satin. With the first brush I used, by the way. Then with this brush, I'm going to go into that lighter gray as well. I'm just going to blend over it. It's a lot darker than I thought it would be today. But that does not really matter. So those are basically the mattes. Now I need to figure out which shimmer I want to use. I like that one a lot, actually. But I also like this one. Maybe I should put this one on my lower lash line. It's going to be a very dark eye, I think. Let's do that first. So I am grabbing this color on a pencil brush. It's going to go underneath my eye, but I'm going to spray it. If I can find my spray. I always misplace my spray. Do I like that? I don't know. But it's on anyway, so let me get an eye pencil. So I have here one from Essence. Let's see if that's the color that I want. I don't know. Let's see what I have here. This is a purple one. Let's reserve judgment on the eye pencil, because I kind of also need to know what lippy I'm going to wear with it. But yeah, so let me blend. Yes, okay. I do have fallout. So just so you know. It's not a huge amount, but I do have it. Still, I need to know the shimmer. I can also use a light gray. I want to use this one first. Let's see what it does dry. Not too shabby. It's very pretty, actually. Okay, now let's spray. I like that. Okay, what I want is that red shade that I have underneath. A little bit on this brush. In the outer corner. To kind of connect the lower lash line and the upper lash and the whatever. You know what I mean, right? Uh-huh. Okay, then a little bit of that gray that I have up top goes here in the outer corner. Let me get a tiny brush. Ah, I have an itchy nose. Let's get this shimmery white. Pretty. Let's see what happens if I spray it. Nice. Okay, I kind of want to re-intensify that red. So this is the eye so far. Let me do the other eye off camera. Put on liner, mascara, lashes and a lippy. And then I will be back and we can discuss how I feel about this palette based on my first impression. So I just wanted to show you the look just before the falsies, mascara and liner and all that goodness is on. I'm going to put on my falsies now, which are going to be my more dramatic ones from, the Social Glam Lash Collection in Style Milan that I get at Primark. I'm going to put those on and then I will be back and I will give you my first impression on everything that is, well, basically new that I used today and my first thoughts on the palette. So hold on tight, I'll be right back. Everything is on and here is the finished look. I'm glad I opted for the more dramatic falsies because I really like how they work with a darker, more smoky look like this. Does that make sense? I hope so. Let's kind of quickly go over the other things that I used. The liquid highlighter. I don't really know why I tried it, because the other liquid highlighters that I have tried do the same thing as this. They tend to break up my foundation. It could very well be that I use too much. I don't know how to use this. I don't like to put it into my foundation. So if you have something like this, let me know how you use it. But yeah, I don't know. Maybe I can try it underneath. I don't know. I will try it and yeah, reserve judgment a little bit. Let's go to the eyeball highlighter. This is a little bit more sheer. But yeah, it does show up. Again, it is underneath my blush and my powder bronzer, just so you know. And it's still nice. And this is how I like my highlighters at the moment. You can build it up. But if you want to shine to the aliens and the gods and all that, you may need to build it up, or maybe even need to spray your brush, you know, and then get the maximum intensity. I haven't tried that, but yeah, for me this is very, very good. Is it the best highlighter I have ever used? No, but it is certainly not the worst. And packaging wise, they are just AAAAA++++. I know that's not a thing, but it does not really matter. So yeah, I love those. The lipstick is really, really comfortable. I knew that because I have already used one of the shades. Let's see if it travels. Not really. Well, tiny bit. A tiny bit, but you can only see it if I do this. And I have had worse. That's also more expensive, darker glosses that do that very, very quickly. So, yeah, I did put a lip liner underneath. Yes, that was what I wanted to say. I did put a lip liner underneath. So, yeah, there's that. But still, I have had much, much worse on the lips. Yeah, again, very, very comfortable. This reminds me of the NYX Butter Glosses, consistency-wise, but a lot lighter. I really, really like this formula. So, I'm going to check out their nudes line. I think they also have... Do they have a vinyl there? I hope so. Because this formula... If there are colors in this range that you like, grab them, because it's really, really comfortable. It doesn't dry down, but it is... It feels like a hydrating lip balm. It's very, very nice. So yeah. Okay, that was that. Here, the palette... I think it's a really good quality, actually, for the reloaded palettes. I have had the Neutrals 3, which was, which was pink-based. I have here the Iconic Division 3, I think. Let me get it. What's it called? Oh, yeah, the Iconic Division, which is kind of their dupe for the Subculture. That one is also really nice, though, but this one... I think the formula is getting better and better. Now, I did swatch this in my haul video, and the shadows felt a little bit drier then. Now that I have swatched it again, they feel creamier. So it's almost like that first top layer kind of held the shadows back a little bit. Sometimes that happens. It is a little bit harder pressed in the pan, but I had no problems whatsoever picking it up with my brush, just so you know. I like the color story, obviously, because that is why I bought it. I also have the Obsession Black is the New Black, which has a color story that is similar to this. Less shades, though, but similar to this. When I felt that one, there was more pigmentation than this. So, if you want this color story, but with, I don't know, a lot more pigmentation right at the beginning of when you dip your brush in, get the Obsession one. If, however, you want to start... with a color story like this, try this one, because you see the look that I have now, it is pretty dark. So yeah, I think that this palette is very, very nice. Oh, do not do that. For the reloaded range, I think that at least until the ones that I have tried, this is the best one quality wise yet. I have a lot of palettes to get through. Maybe the next... I don't know which palette I will play with next. I know some of you want me to play with the Black is the New Black from Obsession. But I don't know yet. Maybe I will get the Take Me to the Grave from Obsession. Because I kind of am feeling that color story. I don't know yet. But I have a lot of palettes to do first impressions with. So a lot will be coming. Just so you know. That was it. That was it for my first impression with, well, some of the stuff from my Halloween haul, including the Reloaded Blackout palette from Makeup Revolution. Let me know down below if you have the palette, if you want the palette, if you have any of the other things that I tried out today, some tips and tricks maybe. Let me know down below. For now, I'm going to thank you very, very much for watching. Don't forget to give the video a thumbs up because it helps me tremendously. Yeah, that was it. I'm going to sign off. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. And I will see you soon in my next one, which will be very soon. Because, as I said, I have quite a few palettes to get through. So yeah, bye guys.